Namaste friends, welcome to Bono Biology Center for True Learning. Here I request you to subscribe our YouTube channel Bono Biology Center and press the bell icon for latest updates and notifications. In this video, we will learn the structure of graafian follicle. What is graafian follicle? A fluid-filled structure in the mammalian ovary within which ovum develops prior to ovulation. Graafian follicle is a type of follicle developed from the tertiary follicle. By looking at this sectional view of the ovary, we are able to see the graafian follicle. In the cortical region of the ovary, there are different developmental stages of the follicles, like primary follicle, secondary follicle, tertiary follicle, and graafian follicle. This is the graafian follicle on which we give our complete focus. This is the structure with cavity which is filled with the fluid within which the egg is developed. This structure, this complete structure, is called a graafian follicle. Here, the detailed clear-cut diagrammatic representation of the graafian follicle is presented. By understanding the labeling of this structure, we will be able to explain the structure of graafian follicle in easy way. Let us first understand the labeled parts. We move from inner to the outside, from here to here we move, right? This round structure is a oocyte, secondary oocyte. Outer to the secondary oocyte, there is a white colored empty portion which is called pre-vitelline space. Then outer to this space, one membrane is present, that is plasma membrane or vitelline membrane. This is plasma membrane. So outer to the plasma membrane, there is another membrane called zona pellucida. This one, zona pellucida. The first inner layer is plasma membrane. The second, that is middle layer, is zona pellucida. Outside to the zona pellucida, there are layers of cells arranged in a radial manner and to form a layer, another layer, which is the third layer envelope the egg, called a corona radiata. This is the corona radiata. Already we saw the layers envelope the human egg in previous videos. Next, come to the cluster of cells completely surrounds the egg. Those are in a dark orange color. They represent the cumulus oophorus. This is the cumulus oophorus. Outer to the cumulus oophorus, there is a empty portion. This white colored empty portion called a Licker folliculi. This empty space is called antrum. This antrum is filled with the fluid. This fluid is called Licker folliculi. Near to the antrum, there are few layers of yellow colored cells arranged in a circle manner called granuloid cells. 1, 2, 3 layers of cells in yellow color. They are called granuloid cells. Outer to the granuloid cells, there is a basement membrane. This is the basement membrane. Outer to the basement membrane, theca is present. The theca is divided into two types. One is theca interna. This is greenish colored cells. The layer of green colored cells represent the theca interna. Outer to the theca interna, yellow colored square shaped cells are present in a layer called theca externa. It is about the structure, I mean the parts of the graafian follicle. Actually, each graafian follicle has a single oocyte, that is immature ovum. In each graafian follicle of the ovary, only one immature ovum is present. Your oocyte contains one nucleus. This block colored dot structure is called nucleus. The nucleus in the graafian follicle is called germinal vesicle. The name of the nucleus in the oocyte is germinal vesicle. The cluster of cells around the oocyte are called cumulus ovophore. This cluster of cells around the oocyte is called cumulus ovophorus, which is also called discus proligerus. Both the names are same. Cumulus ovophorus is also called discus proligerus. What is cumulus ovophorus? The cluster of cells present around the oocyte is called cumulus ovophorus or discus proligerus. Next, granuloid cells, also called follicular cells, they are present around the oocyte within the follicle. These are the granular cells formed in a layer. The number of granuloid cells increases when high levels of gonadotropins are circulating in the blood. The gonadotropins are actually released by the hypothalamus, like follicular stimulating hormone and luteinizing hormone. When their levels increases in the blood, the granuloid cells become large in number. Then the number of same granuloid cells decreases in response to the testosterone hormone. Here, follicular stimulating hormone induces granuloid cells to express luteinizing hormone receptors on their surface. Actually, these granuloid cells have receptors. These receptors are meant for luteinizing hormone. When luteinizing hormone come and binds to the receptors present on these granuloid cells, the proliferation will be stopped. Proliferation means further division of the cells will be stopped. The main hormone responsible for the stoppage of proliferation in granuloid cells is luteinizing hormone. Right. Again, granuloid cells are enclosed, I mean enveloped by a thin layer of extracellular matrix called follicular basement membrane. This is right. This membrane, the follicular basement membrane, it is also called basal membrane. Follicular basement membrane is nothing but basal lamina or fibrovascular coat. Then theca is present outside the basal lamina. This region from here to here represents the basal lamina. Theca is divided into two parts. Theca interna, this region, theca interna. The outer region is theca externa. Here the cells of the theca interna, the cells of the theca interna have receptors for the luteinizing hormone. When luteinizing hormone come and bind to the receptors of the theca interna cells, the precursor for estrogen is produced or developed. Actually, the theca interna cells are the main sources for production of the estrogen. Theca interna cells differentiate into theca lutein cells of the corpus luteum. Later on, the theca interna cells transformed into the lutein cells of the corpus luteum. Already we know how the corpus luteum structure is formed. This corpus luteum is the yellowish structure containing the lutein cells. The main functioning of the lutein cells is a production of the androgens, estrogen and progesterone hormone. Then theca externa is found outside the theca interna. The theca externa is developed from the connective tissue. the portion of an ovarian follicle filled with fluid, right? This portion, this white colored the portion is called antrum. Antrum. This antrum is filled with fluid. This fluid is called liquor folliculi. Thank you for watching this video.